Hello everyone, in this tutorial I'm going to be explaining how to optimize your Nvidia control panel for extreme performance. So we're going to be going through all the settings and completely tweaking the options to be strictly for performance and kind of preferring performance over quality. So you might notice a little bit of quality difference after these settings have been tweaked. So to open your Nvidia control panel, you want to go to the search bar or to the system tray. You want to right click the icon and then click Nvidia control panel, or you can go to the search bar and look up Nvidia control panel and then open it. Once it's open, you're going to see a program like this, and the first thing you're going to want to do is go down to use my preference, and then you're going to slide this bar all the way to performance and click apply. After that, you're going to want to go to use the advanced 3D image settings, and the reason why we are doing this is because in game, if the Nvidia control panel somehow takes over your settings, it will still target max performance over quality. And then make sure to click apply again one more time once you have this setting selected, and then we can move on to our next section called manage 3D settings. The first option is image scaling. We're going to turn that off. You can have this on if you prefer more FPS, but I personally don't like the way it makes my game look. If you don't know what this setting does, it basically makes your GPU render a higher resolution than what your game is. So say you're playing Valorant and you are on a 1080p monitor. You could set your game to 720p, and then your GPU would upscale it and make it look close to 1080p, but you would lose some visual quality, and I personally prefer my image quality over than just a few extra FPS. This could benefit you a lot though, so depending on what you prefer, I would turn this on or off. For ambient occlusion, I have this off. For filtering, I have this off. For FXAA, I also have this off. Gamma correction, I have on. For mode, I have off. And since I have mode off, the settings and transparency will also be on none and off. Background application max refresh rate. If you don't know what this is, it is essentially, say you have Minecraft open and you have Roblox open. Minecraft is running in the background and you are just chilling on Roblox or something while some iron smelts. Minecraft will be, say, running at 120 FPS and Roblox will be at 60. And since Minecraft is in the background and you're not focused on it, you would want your GPU to focus more on Roblox, right? So if you have background application max refresh rate on, that means since it's in the background, instead of being on 120 FPS, say you limited it to 60, your Minecraft will now be stuck at 60 until you tab back into the application. So I personally don't like this, but some people might find this really useful. So once again, depending on what you prefer, I'm going to leave this off. Going down to our next setting, we have GPU or CUDA GPUs. I have this on all. My DSR factors are on off. And since I have that off, my DSR smoothness is also off. For low latency, this is also more preferred on, but I like to have mine on ultra because I prefer a little less frames for less latency. If you have this on ultra, it shouldn't cause too much of a big difference to frames, but for some people it might and for some people it not. So I have mine on ultra because I would like to sacrifice a little bit of frames over FPS. For max frame rate, I have that off. For multi-frame, I have that off. For open GLGDI compatibility, I have this on preferred performance. On OpenGL rendering GPU, I have this on my current GPU, my RTX 3060. I have power management on normal instead of prefer max performance, because what it does is when it's on max performance, it gets rid of your GPU's idle state. And what that means is, say you load up a game and it is running 100%, trying to get you every FPS possible, and then you close your game and your GPU kind of relaxes and slows down because it's not needed to run at 100%. This prefer maximum performance kind of gets rid of that relaxing state, which I don't like personally, so I still let my GPU have the relaxing state. And keep in mind that if it is on normal, when you launch a game, it'll still boost up to 100%. So if you want it running constantly at its highest performance, I would recommend setting to prefer maximum performance. For preferred refresh rate, set this to highest available. For shader cache size, this will depend on the size of your C drive. I have mine on 10 gigabytes because I have a 1 terabyte SSD for my C drive. I think 100 gigabytes is a bit excessive, but it's all personal preference. So what this will do if you have it higher is the more games you play, it'll keep stored more shaders for you. So if you play a game once a year and you go back to it for the first time in a year, it will still have your shaders if you haven't reset your computer, and it won't need to download them or anything like that unless there's new ones. So I like to have mine selected at 10 gigabytes personally. And then the next option, you'd like to set this one to on. And then for LOD bias, you'd like to set this to allow. For quality, set this to high performance. For trillionaire optimization, set this to on. For threaded optimization, I have this set on auto. For triple buffer, I have this on off. Vertical sync, I also have this off. And then if you have a VR, this is a debatable option for you. So 2 will have the best performance for you, like FPS and input latency. And then 1 pre-rendered frames will result in the best quality. And I don't have a cord with my Quest. I use AirLink. So I use 2 because I would very much prefer maximum performance over quality, since AirLink is kind of dog water. It is not good whatsoever. And then virtual reality, variable rate, I have this on off. And then Vulkan or / OpenGL preset method, you should leave this to auto unless you have a preference on what happens. After you've did that, you want to make sure you click apply and then go down to configure surround and physics. So once you're in physics X settings, you want to make sure you select your NVIDIA graphics card and then click apply. And once you've done that, you head down to display resolution. And for here, you want to scroll down until you get to the PC section and select your highest available resolution or the resolution that says native. And then you want to make sure you have your highest refresh rate available. And if you don't have your highest refresh rate available here, say you have 165 hertz, just say my monitor had, but the only option is 144. You could make a custom resolution by doing what I just did, and then setting the refresh rate here. Just say 165 is a refresh rate. You can click test, and then if it works, your screen will go black, turn back on, and then it will let you keep the custom resolution you made. And then you can go and select your highest refresh rate here. You can also overclock your monitors here if they do support it. I have a 60 hertz Dell monitor for my main Discord monitor. And it is a normal 60 hertz monitor, but I created a custom resolution here and set it to 1600 900 by 75 hertz. And there is another option you could do. Some monitors or TVs might have it. I have a Philips TV connected, so when I want to get some good quality in for my games, I can play them at 4K. I go above my native resolution because that's what my TV supports, and this will be the best quality for my options. So make sure once you've did all of these that you click apply, and we can move on to our next option. Our next option will be down towards the bottom under video. You click adjust video color settings, and then you want to make sure for every monitor or TV you have, you select with the NVIDIA settings, and then you click advanced, and then you make sure this option is on full dynamic range. What this will do for you is essentially let your monitors and TVs have the best color for you and what they can provide. So if you do this, you might notice a little bit change in color. If you don't like it, you can just simply go back to this option up here. And if you do, well, I'm glad I could help you out with some better colors on your monitor and TV. Other than that, there is not much I can do for you guys, and this has been the best FPS optimization for the Nvidia control panel. If you guys would like to see more or a AMD version of this, just let me know in the comments. I will gladly make one for you guys, and I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.